Hello everyone, welcome to today's lecture, and today we are going to talk about clipping. So far we have looked at how to rasterize shapes in 2D, and we have looked at the raster and the vector image models, and we have learned a significant bit about OpenGL, right? So we are moving forward our discussion today with some specifics about how, some more specifics about how things get drawn to the window. So if you remember, then we started our discussion of the image formation model in CG by looking at an abstract model like this, and we said that we have a virtual world with 3D objects where we know the surface material properties of these objects, and we have light sources which are point light sources, and we have a raster image model, and we have a pinhole camera. And what we started our discussion of computer graphics with was by looking at the raster image model. So today we are going to start looking at another component of this image formation model, and that is the pinhole camera. So the pinhole camera model, the math for the pinhole camera model is pretty simple. Given given a point like P, X, Y, Z in the 3D world, which is say the tip of this orange arrow, right? We set up our camera by specifying what we call the camera center, which in this case is the origin O, right? And we say that if I join this point P, X, Y, Z with the camera center and let that projector, so this ray that is joining the point P with the camera center is known as a projector. This projector goes and intersects a plane that we call the image plane at some point x comma y. So this image plane is at some distance f from the point O, right? And this distance f is measured along the z axis in the way in this coordinate system that we have set up in this diagram. And if I take a plane perpendicular to this axis at this distance f, then that is my image plane. The quantity f is known as the focal length of this camera, and the point where the projector goes and intersects the image plane, which is x comma y, the small x comma small y, which gives me this point small p. This point small p is the image of capital P. Okay, and using similar triangles, it is very easy to write that x is equal to minus f x by z, and y is equal to minus f y by z. The minus is coming because the image plane is located a distance f from the origin in the negative direction of x. Okay, now we have certain names for these vectors. The z axis in this case is called the look at vector or the look at direction. The y axis, that in general tells you which is the direction that is up for the camera. So when you hold a camera, for example, when you take a picture using your phone in landscape mode, then the short edge of your phone might be the up vector, direction of the up vector. However, when you change it to portrait mode, the long edge of your when you change it to portrait mode, the short edge continues to be the up vector, but now the up vector has turned. Okay, so the up direction is the upright direction of the camera. So that is why you see that sometimes when you rotate your phone and take a picture and you save it, sometimes it appears rotated in some image viewers because they do not correct for the rotation of the camera. The third axis, which is the x-axis, is generally set up as a cross product between these two vectors. We will see more about setting up of camera coordinate systems later when we talk about camera transforms, in the lecture that discusses viewing transformations. The camera center, or the which is the origin in this case, is also called the eye. Okay. And in this particular slide, we have redrawn the previous image. And what we have done, we have brought the imaging plane from behind, from being on the other side of the camera center to the front of the camera center, right? So now our imaging plane is in the middle of our world and the eye. And though this one is more realistic, so for an actual real camera, you might think that this is the center of the lens assembly and this is your imaging sensor and this is the world. So this makes sense physically. This does not make sense physically because how can the imaging plane be between the camera center and the world? But this makes our lives easier mathematically because it eliminates the minus sign from our equations and we get an upright image instead of an inverted image. So since anyway this is a synthetic camera model, we are free to do whatever we want. We do not exactly have to represent what is out there in reality. So we assume that our image plane is to the front, a distance f away from the camera. And now we can do similar triangles between this. We can do similar triangles between this triangle and the bigger triangle with the in the world. And it gives us these two equations, which is x is equal to f x by z and y is equal to f x y z, right? Now, given the position of the eye and the look at vector and the up vector, so we are given these three things. Is that enough to define our camera? Okay. Is that all we need to define the camera and form the image? So if you think about it a little bit, you will realize that we also need the size of the image, right? Because we just said that it's an image plane. But a plane has infinite extents, so we need our image to have finite extents. So we need to specify the size of our image. Now there are various ways in which you can specify the size of the image. You can either specify the width and the height directly, or what you can do is that you can specify one of them. And you can specify an aspect ratio. So the aspect ratio is the ratio of width is to height. So very often you will see aspect ratios like 4:3 or 16:9. Those are the common aspect ratios, or 16:10. They are generally used for screens, but they come from images. Okay. And another way of specifying the size of the image is frequently by specifying the field of view. So OpenGL has this specification where you specify the vertical field of view, which is represented by theta here in this diagram. So this is the vertical field of view. And because you know this distance f, right? So you know the distance f from the I to this point on the image plane where the z-axis intersects the image plane. This distance is f. So given the angle theta, you can figure out the height of the image, and then if you are given the aspect ratio, you can figure out the width of the image. So you can also be given theta, which is the field of view, or FOVY. So FOVY is the vertical field of view along with the aspect ratio that gives you the size of the image. Now The one thing I forgot to mention is that the z-axis, which is the axis that is perpendicular to the image plane and it passes through the camera center, is also known as the principal axis. And the point where the principal axis intersects the image plane is known as the principal point. So the focal length F is measured between the principal point and the camera center or the eye. So what happens now if I shift this window, right? So this window appears like it is kind of centered, but kind of centered so that this arrow is completely within view. But you can imagine that you can move your camera, or you can even point it a little downwards. So sort of like rotating the camera about the x-axis so that it points downwards. That will shift my window down. Or I might just translate the camera downwards. That will also shift the window down, the image plane, the image window, sorry. So if the window is shifted downwards, what will happen is that the scene will get clipped. So you can see what happened, that the image moved downwards and the scene got clipped. This is very easy to see, and you see it all the time. If you take a window on your laptop screen such that half of it goes out of the laptop screen, then that half essentially gets clipped. So clipping means that you throw away the part of whatever it is that you are drawing on the screen that lies outside your window, and you do not draw it because essentially there is no place to draw it. You never draw outside your window. So that we will return back to the synthetic camera model later when we will talk about viewing transforms. The subject of today's the main subject of today's lecture is clipping, and how do you do this clipping?